In this video, we'll be speaking on hinge joint 2D in Unity. A hinge joint 2D allows a game object controlled by rigid body physics to be attached to a point in space around which it can rotate. So in order to understand this, let's take up the example. In this game, I have a ball and I have a wooden plank. I want that this wooden plank be attached to a point in the world. There should be a point in the world where this gets attached to and it rotates around that point. So in order to do that, what I have to do is I simply need to add the component named hinge joint 2D. I just need to do this and you will get this entire component. Run this game. You will see that when the ball hits the log or the plank, it rotates on an axis or on a certain fixed point. Now, which point does it rotate on? So in order to understand this, I have gone to the scene view and I look at the anchor. Anchor is at 0, 0, and I have a connected anchor. So what they two basically mean? Now in order to edit these two values, I'll have to untick this auto configure connected anchor. When this auto configure connected anchor is ticked, the anchors get automatically configured. But since I have to do it manually, I will untick this. I'll zoom it up for you. So in this one dot, there are actually two dots. One is the anchor and the other is the connected anchor. So in order to distinguish them, I'll just move the X to a certain point. So this is the outer dot and the one that is inside, the blue one, it is the connected anchor. So what this connected anchor does? This connected anchor is in world space. That means it is that point on which this game object rotates in the world space. And the anchor, this one, the one with just the outer ring, this is the real anchor or the actual anchor of this game object. This anchor is in the local space of this game object, and wherever this is placed, the entire game object will rotate around that point. I'll just move this connected anchor to a tad bit right. So this connected anchor is in the world space. This is this point where this entire game object will rotate. And this is the point or the anchor where this game object will rotate about, or keeping this as a reference, the entire game object will revolve around this. So when I run this game, the rotation will start from here. That is, this point will come here. I'll run it for you. For better understanding, I have switched the game view to below and scene view to above. So as I told before, this connected anchor has been shifted to the right. And this will be the starting point where the rotation will take place. Just run this. If you see below and above, that point where the anchor is set, that moved to the right and the rotation started from there. So this is all about the anchor and the connected anchor property. Now we want to rotate this game object by attaching it to another game object. It should not be a point in space, but it should be a point on the game object. So in order to do this, I will just make visible the second plank. Make sure that this plank has a rigid body 2D connected to it. And also make sure that the body type of this rigid body is set to kinematic. That is, we don't want to make it move under the physics forces. Now, in order to rotate this plank by attaching it to a point in the other game object, all I need to do is go to the hinge joint component of the wooden plank, drag and drop the second plank onto the connected rigid body slot. I also need to set the anchor and the connected anchor in order to move the first plank with respect to the second plank. So in order to do this, I'll once again untick this auto configure connect tick box. I'll move it to zeros. Now in order to move this, I have zoomed it up. What I need to do is I need to set the anchor and the connected anchor. So I'll just move it a little bit and I'll bring it to a point somewhere between these two wooden planks. Also, I'll take the second connected anchor property and move it to the point in between these two planks. Now, the second lock will rotate with a point as a reference from the first lock. Let's run it. Now, if you look at this, you will see that this plank does rotate about a point on the other game object. But the problem is that it is not colliding with the second game object. So in order for the collision to happen, you will have to set a property that is enable collision to true in the hinge joint component. So when I tick this enable collision property and run this game, you will see that it collides with the other game object. Now, a lot of times we also want that when the game object comes down and goes to the other end, it also comes back to its original place. So in order for that to happen, we have to make use of the useMotor property. If I need to move anti-clockwise in order to bring this lock to its original place, then I'll have to set the motor speed to a negative value. Motor speed is the speed applied on the game object using which it will rotate, and maximum motor force is the force applied on the game object to reach this motor speed. So since here I need to move in an anti-clockwise direction, I'll set this to a negative 100 and the maximum motor force I'll apply it to 10. You also need to make sure that the use motor checkbox is ticked in order for using this property. So after ticking it, let's run this game. We'll see that after it has gone to the other end or collided with the second lock, it comes back to its original position. So this is about motor or use motor property. Next is the use limits property. If you don't want the wooden plank to rotate completely, then you can use the use limits property. The use limits property limits the movement of the wooden plank by the amount of value that we have set in its angle properties. So there's a lower angle value and there's an upper angle value. So I'll keep the lower angle to 0 and the upper angle to suppose 45. And in order to use this, we'll have to tick this use limits checkbox. So here you could see a small angle on a gizmo. Now in order to clearly understand this, I have taken the game view to bottom and the scene view above. Let's run this game and check. You will see that this wooden lock will come to a maximum distance of this angle and then come back to its original place. So this is how the use limits property works. Here you have to set the lower angle and the upper angle. The final two properties are the brake force and the brake torque property. The brake force property is the amount of force that is applied to this game object such that it snaps out from the attached game object. So if we apply a force that is bigger than the value set here, then this wooden plank will snap off from the attached game object. So I'll just make this value to a 10 and run this game. What this states to us is that the force applied by the ball onto the log has a greater value than 10, and hence the wooden log comes off from the attached game object. Similarly, the brake torque. If we set the brake torque to a value and if there is any other torque that exceeds this value, then this wooden plank will snap off from the attached game object. So I hope you understood about the hinge joint 2D.
Make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so you get notified of the new video that I post here on YouTube. Thank you for watching.